Hello everyone, welcome back to the session. So in the previous session we have seen about the what is the system testing. Okay, so how system testing will be done. So this is the block diagram for the system testing. So once again we recall the process, what is the system testing. So in system testing, first we will go for the set up the test environment, and then we go for the generate the test cases, and then we will go for the generate the testing data. So after taking the, some testing cases, like testing cases means, so if you give the x is equal to some 0, y equal to some 2, so what is the output? If x is equal to some 3, y is equal to some 4, then what is the result? Okay, like that some test cases will be generated according to the software. So after the generating of the test cases, then they will generate the testing data. So whatever the cases they have taken, so first they have to note down what type of cases we have to take. Okay, so after that they will imply all the test cases whatever they noted. So they have to generate the testing data. So after the generating of the testing data, so they have to execute the test cases. So according to the requirements, so if I giving the x is equal to 1, y is equal to 2, I have to get the output as a some z is equal to 3. Okay, like that I have to note down the all the test cases. So after noting the test cases, then I have to check, so whether this is the testing data is correct or not, whether it is what type of data types I have given. So I have to, first we have to check. Then I will go for the execution of the those test cases. Then I will go for the, so what is the errors I am getting while generating of the, while executing the some test cases. What types of the errors, debugging means what type of the errors I am getting. Okay, we have to report. Report means we have to write down everything. So after then we have to do the regression testing. So like a smoke test. In regression testing we have there 4 types of the testings. Like a smoke test or some test in, for whatever the remaining 4 tests. So those tests will be done in the regression testing according to the project, according to the software what they are developing. So and then after getting the regression testing, again they have to what are the defects in that. So what type of the log defects? So while entering into the system, while entering into the software, so what type of the logging defects they are getting? So they have to note them. And again they go for the retest. Okay, so this is the process of the system testing. And next coming to, so what types of the system testings are there? So what type? So we have seen the different types of testings. Okay, in system testing also we have the different types of the testings. So what are they? So let us go for the first one. So first one is a performance testing. So what do you mean by the performance testing? So performance testing is a type of software testing. So that is carried out to test the speed, scalability, stability and reliability of the software product or application. So performance, what do you mean by the performance? So how we calculate the performance of a system? So by checking of the speed. So how much speed it is getting to open the system, how much speed it is taking to shut down the system, how much speed it is taking to open it to different tasks. Okay, like that. Scalability. So how much area it is occupied. So what is the different, I mean, what are the, how much space it is occupying. So by storing of some data. Like that. Scalability. And reliability. We have seen the, what is the reliability. So if there is any external environment is interacting with the system or software, so what type of reliability it is giving? So reliability. So we have to, that is the, comes under the performance testing. So in system testing, the first one is the performance testing. And second one is the load testing. So what is the mean by the load testing? So load testing is a type of testing, so which is carried out to determine the behavior of the system or software product under extreme load. Extreme load means, if you are giving the more type of data like that, for example, we can say like, so downloading, okay. So you are getting the downloading of the so much of data. So while downloading, how much time it is taking? So how much load it is getting on the software or for uploading? So if you are getting to upload some 100 GB data, so then what type of load it is taking off? Okay, like that. So we have to check the how it is carried out to determine the behavior of the system. So how it is behaving when we keep the some load on it. Load means not some weight, So let us say copying of the files, like, or simultaneously working with this, some different task at a time. Okay, multitask at a time. So those are called as a learning. Okay, and next, this is the second one. And thirdly, stress testing. So what do you mean by stress testing? Stress testing is a type of software testing performed to check the robustness of the system under the varying loads. So loads means here we can give the some copying files, or else we can give the some keeping of some external environment in external environment, or keeping the some data transferring from one site to the another site, like that, different types of the load, like that. So if there is some testing, so that is called as a stress testing. So it is used to check the robustness of the system. That means how it is going to be calculating the such load is applying on that. So how it is performing. So whether it is going to be slow or whether it is going to be taking a fast speed, how much speed it is acquiring, how much load is it is capable, like that. There is a stress testing. And next, coming to the fourth one, is a scalability testing. So what is a scalability testing? So scalability testing is a type of software testing which is carried out to check the performance of a software application or system in terms of its capability to scale up or scale down the number of user request load. For example, if it is a website. Let us say if it is a website. Okay, so this scalability testing mainly applicable for the websites. So in websites, so client, so we are the clients. Okay, so those who are interacting with the web browser, those are the clients. Server is whatever through the web browser we are requesting, those that is called as a server. Okay, for example, Gmail, like Google. Okay, so let us take Google. So Google means we are regularly opening this Gmail. Let us talk with the Gmail. Okay. So in our browsers means we have different types of the browsers. Okay, Chrome, Internet Explorer, or Mozilla. And next, Opera. Microsoft Edge. So this is a newly coming, the Microsoft Edge is coming the newly. So for last 2 months almost, Microsoft Edge is came into existence. Okay, so most popular things we have known is these. Okay, and also UC browser. So these are the browsers. These are the browsers. Through these browsers we are going to open our applications, web applications. Okay, web applications means like the Gmail or Amazon or Flipkart or eBay. So whatever thing is, Wikipedia. Okay, so those are the web applications. Okay, so first we are going the example for the Gmail. So in order to open the Gmail, you have to go for any of the six of these browsers. Okay, just let's go for the Chrome. So I opened the Chrome in order to open the Gmail. So after in Chrome, in web search, I have to give the Gmail. So then it's give the list of some links. In that, I will go for the Gmail login. So then it will open the login page. So in login page, what we are giving, so we will give the some credentials. What are those? Username and password. You will give the username and password. So after this, giving the username and password, you will just click on the login button. Okay, so when you click on the login button, what will happen is this login button will take the request. That means these are the username and password. This username and password from such a certain IP address of this web browser is requesting to access the Gmail account. So it will take the request to the, so this is the client. This is the client environment. This will go to the server. So Google means like a other country. Okay, let us say it is in US. So server is in US. So client here requesting. So what he was requesting? Gmail account. So he is given, he has given the username and password. So after giving the username and password, he went for the login. So when you click on the login button with your mouse pointer or with your touch or voice, through voice, whatever command you are given, okay, it will take the one request to the server. So we call this as a request. So when this request went to the server will check the details. Whatever the username you have given, whatever the password you have given, with those username, with that password is correct or not, is correctly matched or not, is there any mistakes or not. So if it is correct, then it will give the response. So we will get the response. So what is the response? Response in the form of, it will open your Gmail account. So whatever the inboxes, primary or updates or social or forums, whatever it is, tab, different tabs. So you will get the Gmail account. You will get the Gmail account of yours. Okay. If the password and username are not correct, so then it gives a response as the login is failed. So incorrect password or incorrect username, like that, it will give some message. Okay. So this is the client server. The same thing is the scalability test. So in scalability testing, the type of software which is carried out to check the performance of a software application in terms of scalability, scale up or scale down the number of user requests flowed. That means, so what I said, so once a certain user request will go. So like that, how many people will interact at the same time, at the same, what we can say, at the same, coincidentally, at the same time, so many of the people, not in within the country, out of the country, overworld, overall the world. So everyone will use the Gmail. So many members will log in at the same time. Some members will log in some of the time. Okay. So how much user it is accepting? So how much load it is accepting? Like that, how many requests it can accept at the same time? Sometimes, like let us say, if you go for the some online exams, sometimes you will get the some errors. You can't able to open the thing. Or else if you go for the examination portal. So in examination portal, what do people do? For example, it has a given time of 15 days. People will not done the within 14 days. You will sit only on the last date. So at the last date, what will happen? So many people at a time will request the server to pay the fee at the same time. Then what will happen? The server will not respond. That is, there is a scalability testing will be performed at that time. So how much load it is taking? So how much users request it is accepting at the same time? That is a scalability test. So okay, so these are the four types of the testings. So what are those? First one is the performance. Second one is the load. Third one is stress. And fourth one is the scalability. So these are the different types of the testing. Okay, and next topic is the art of debugging. So up to now we have seen the different types of the testing. So what type of testings will do for what purposes? So what type of web applications is, will do the some sort of testings? What type of testings will be done for the web applications? Okay, testings are different from the different things. So for systems or softwares, it will, the testing is different. For web applications, the testings are different. Okay, so we have seen the different types of testings also. Now let us come for the debugging. So what is meant by debugging? Bug. Okay, so bug. Bug means error. So meaning of bug is error. So debugging, that means error modification. So the art of debugging, the art of removing errors. So how? So let us go further. Software testing is a process that can be systematically planned and specified. Yes, testing will have to be done in a planning manner. So if you doesn't plan anything, if you done testing blindly, then you will not get able to find out the errors. That's why the system testing should be in a planning manner. Okay, specific plan. You have to follow the some systematic plan. So test case design can be conducted, a strategy can be defined, and results can be evaluated against the prescribed expectations. That means, so while before going to the testing, okay, so if you're given the inputs like this, so I will get the output like that. So we have some expectations. Expected outputs will be there. So expected output and the exact result output. So after working with it, what are the results? Okay. So like that. For example, if you will write some lab experiments. So in lab experiments, you will write some expected output. So after conducting your lab exam, so what is the output, real output you will write. Okay, like that also, like that the same process will be applied in the testing. So in testing also, they will write the some expected output. So if you give in the inputs like this, so we will get the output like that. Okay, so after before testing, they wrote down all the expectations. So after then, they will go for the testing. Okay. So debugging occurs as a consequence of the successful testing. So when debug will occurs, so debugging will occur as a consequence of the successful testing. So by testing, consequently, that means we will go in the testing in a consequence manner, in a sequence manner, then we will get the debugging. That means debugging means removing of the error. Okay. So when we can remove the error continuously if you go for the testing. And next, debugging is a process that results in the removal of the error. So what has it? So debugging is nothing but, so this is the definition. So debugging is nothing but it is a process that results in the removal of the error. Okay, debugging is removal of error. It's a process of removal of error. So by testing. And next, so all the debugging can and should be an orderly process. It is still very much an art. So a software engineer evaluating the results of a test is often confronted within symptomatic indication of a software problem. So when he is evaluating of the test, so after the testing is done, so he will get some evaluation. So okay, this test we have done. So after doing this test, so this type of outputs we got, this type of some errors we got, like that he had to evaluate everything. So and this is the indication of the software problem. So while he is evaluating, if he get any problems, that means the software is going to having some problem. That is, external manifestation of the error and the internal cause of the error may have no obvious relationship to one another. So whatever the errors we are getting, so while testing, that is the internal error. So external error is different, internal error is different. So there is no relationship between those two. So that is this point. And the poorly understood mental process that connects a symptom to cause is a debugging. Okay, so let's go for the next. So debugging process. Up to now we have seen the what is the art of debugging. So what is the art of debugging? Debugging is nothing but it's a process of evaluation. It's a process of removing of an error. So why we have to remove error? So in order to get the expected results. What are the expected results we have? So according to that, in order to get those expected outputs, so we will go for the debugging of a debugging. Okay. So now what we do in the debugging process? So debugging is not testing, but always occurs as a consequence of the testing. So debugging is not a testing process. So it is clear. So debugging is not a testing process, but the debugging will occurs when we go for the some consequences of the testing. Consequences means, so serial manner, if you go on testing, you will get the some errors internally. Okay. So that is the debugging. So the debugging process begins with the execution of a test case. So when the debugging is occurs, when you're executing of the some test cases, for example, so I have written a program, okay. So I want the addition of the two numbers. I have written this program. Okay. So what is the logic I have written? So addition of two numbers. So this is a program I have written. So what I get is, what I want is, when I have given the some test cases, I have noted some test cases, okay? Like let us say test case 1. So in this test case 1, I want to take two variables, let us say x is equal to 2, y is equal to 3. So then the output, expected output should be 5. So this is example I'm giving. Okay, next test case 2. When I given the x is equal to some 4.2, y is equal to some 1.5, then output, the resultant output I want to get as 5.7. Okay, like that I want to make a some test cases. Okay, like that I have to write some test cases. So now what I have given, so first after going for the while the execution, so I will give these values. So what is the output I have given? Expected output is 5. So then what is the result? It is generated by the system software, by the software. What is the output? Okay, so I have to know, like that for this output also. So when executing these values, then you will get some errors. So if you write the C program, so whatever the faculty has given, so you implemented the same thing in the Turbo C. Okay, you will write in that environment. So after then you are executing the program, what you will get? You will get some errors. So whatever called as compile time errors or runtime errors. So runtime errors means sometimes it may be warnings, you will not bother about that. Let us leave the compile time errors. Maybe some semicolon we have missed, or maybe some for loop we have missed, and some quotation marks. Okay, like that. So some syntactical errors. So those are called as a debug. So the called as a bugs. Okay. So while executing of the test cases, we will get the bugs. So debugging is not testing, but always occurs as a consequence of testing. Okay, next, the debugging process begins with the execution of the test case. That's what we have seen. So results are assessed and a lack of correspondence between expected and actual performance is encountered. So previous example, I have seen the expected output is a 5, but I have got the some result after running the test case. I got the some result as 8. So that is called as an error. Okay, that is called as a bug. So in many cases, the non-corresponding data are a symptom of an underlying cause as it hidden. Okay. So whatever the non-correspondence data means, that whether it is a what type of data we are giving. So we have to check. So in the previous test case, I have given the some float values. So whether those float values are also taken by the system or by the software or not, I have to check. Okay. And next, the debugging process attempts to match the symptom with the cause, thereby leading to error correction. So what is the debugging process? In debugging process, we have to, what is the cause? So why I am getting the output as 8 instead of 5? So what is the, is there any problem with the logic? If you go for the HackerRank site, you can able to see the so many of the problems with the C or C++ or Java, whatever the language you want, Python. Okay, so in those they will give you some, for example, you are getting some coding club. In coding club, we have given some expected output. Okay, so in that expected output, you people will check. So according to that, you are getting the output or not. Result, what we can exact result, the same thing. Okay, so while you are doing the program, you will get the so many of the errors. You have to rectify those. So the debugging process attempts to match symptom with cause, thereby leading to error correction. We have to make some error corrections in that. Okay. And next, coming to, so debugging process. So the debugging process will have always the two outcomes. So whatever the debugging, the process will have the two outcomes. What are those? The cause will be found and corrected. So what is the main cause in order to get the wrong output? So what is the cause? We have to find and we have to correct there itself. And next, second one, the cause will not be found. Sometimes we will see, sometimes if you run some programs, we didn't get any compilation errors, we didn't get any runtime errors, but the output we don't get. Where is the problem? So where we are getting the problem? So like that. So those errors we can't able to correct. okay, sometimes we cannot get it. That means we cannot find out what is the cause for that error. Okay, we didn't find. Maybe that is related with some design process, okay, like that. In the latter case, the person performing debugging may suspect a case, design testers to help validate the suspicion and work toward error correction in an iterative fashion. So in this, the cause will not be found. So if it isn't found any cause for the error, what it is happening? Okay, let us go for the some design process. Okay, in the design itself, if there is any error, so we have to check in the design process and we have to check in a iterative manner. Iterative manner is nothing but, so after designing process, so what is we getting? So like that, we have to increment in incremental model. We have to check the output. Okay, and next coming to. So in all likelihood, human psychology has more to do with an answer than software technology. However, a few characteristics of the box provided some clues. Okay, so although we have so many of the bugs, although we have seen so many type of the bugs, according to the human psychology, they have given us some of the characteristics in order to find a bug. So what is a bug? We wanted to know, okay, this is so here there is a bug is occurred. How we can calibrate? So there are some characteristics. They are provided some characteristics. What are those? The first point, the symptom and the cause may be geographically remote. That is, the symptom may appear.